If you can't figure out why you seem to feel better on a diet of refined grains, or maybe if you feel better when you take multivitamins that have what you thought was synthetic folic acid, a really low quality ingredient, then this video is for you. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and you're watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about why sometimes synthetic folic acid can be better than natural food folate. This is a little confusing because many people in the natural health communities correctly understand that folic acid does not occur in the food supply. It's synthetic. It's different from natural food folate. And in fact, it requires metabolism that natural food folates don't require. And there are some people who aren't as good at metabolizing it as others. And so for a lot of people, it's not a very good source of folate. All of those things are true, but there's more to the story than that. We can say that there are methylated folates, there are unmethylated folates, and there's synthetic folic acid. Folate deficiency and vitamin B12 deficiency can both cause a particular type of anemia called macrocytic anemia. It's a dysfunction of your red blood cells, just like iron deficiency anemia, but the way that you would notice it is if your doctor ordered a complete blood count and the mean corpuscular volume, or MCV, is elevated. That means that your red blood cells are way bigger than they should be. And it's because your folate deficiency has stopped them from being able to divide. It's the unmethylated form of folate that is supporting red blood cell development. In fact, the role of vitamin B12, the reason that vitamin B12 deficiency produces anemia, is because it takes methyl groups off of folate to make the unmethylated form of folate available for producing red blood cells. Now, if you look at natural food folate, there are lots of natural unmethylated folates in foods. However, there's a lot of vegetables that almost exclusively contain methyl folate. If you get synthetic folic acid from refined grains to which it's been added to prevent birth defects in women who weren't expecting to get pregnant or didn't know about prenatal vitamins, if you're eating that, that isn't methylated. And so as long as you are able to process it in the way that it enters into your metabolic pathways, that will support red blood cell health and prevent anemia. Whereas the methylated forms of folate in vegetables won't necessarily do that. Now, as long as you have adequate B12 status, it shouldn't make a difference, because if you eat the methylated forms of folate in your leafy greens, B12 will be there to take the methyl group off, folate will support your red blood cell health. But if you run vitamin B12 deficient, either because you don't eat enough, or you have digestive problems, or you have a family history of pernicious anemia, but you've never investigated in your own self. And let's face it, how many of us have even looked at our B12 status? It's not routinely tested for. So if you're running low in B12, the synthetic folic acid could be making you feel good because it's the one thing preventing you from developing the folate deficiency anemia. And because you're low in B12, the food folate from the leafy greens isn't going to do the same thing. Add on top of all of this that synthetic folic acid, despite all its downsides, is more stable in processed foods than the natural food folates are. Not only that, but it's a lot easier to digest. The folic acid in those supplements doesn't require the digestive processes that natural food folates do. And so synthetic folic acid has higher bioavailability, which means if you take a certain dose, you'll absorb a lot more of it than you will of natural food folates. So if you feel better when you eat refined grains, or you feel better when you take synthetic folic acid supplements or multivitamins that have synthetic folic acid in it, then one thing that you should investigate is your folate status, because it's very possible that your folate status could decline when you're trying to eat more healthily. The best way to look at whether this is happening is MCV, or mean corpuscular volume on a complete blood count. You can go to directlabs.com and order a complete blood count for $29. You can just go to your doctor and go in for a physical. Your doctor probably should be ordering a complete blood count, and it would probably be really, really easy to ask your doctor to order one. So if this may apply to you, I would strongly encourage you to look at your folate status. If your folate status is running low, I'm not saying that you should eat refined grains, but you should make an intensive effort around trying to boost your consumption of natural food folates and investigate whether a supplement is right for you. Exactly how to do all that, I'll unpack in the next video.